Here's the breaking news we have now in the special counsel investigation involving President Trump's former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, and his communications with the Russians. Manafort's legal team has just filed new documents in court today. And guess what? They failed to redact a portion of those filings. And as a result, we now are learning that Manafort met with Russian Konstantin Kilimnik in Madrid while he managed Trump's presidential campaign. Before today, that Madrid meeting wasn't known. The filing says that Manafort discussed a Ukrainian peace plan with the Russian and shared political data related to the 2016 campaign. Special Counsel Robert Mueller accused Manafort of lying about five different topics during the cooperation interviews, including his communication with this Russian. And in today's filing, Manafort's lawyers continue to insist he didn't mean to lie, but they say they do not want to challenge the accusations in court. So, Garrett Graff is with me, author of The Threat Matrix, Inside Robert Mueller's FBI and the War on Global Terror. So, Garrett, good to see you. Why don't we start with the fact that he apparently shared with this individual polling data from the 2016 campaign as he was the Trump campaign chairman. How significant is that?
It's quite significant is the short answer. And boy, Paul Manafort, the story of Paul Manafort's prosecution by Robert Mueller is the story of Paul Manafort not being able to use technology correctly. I mean, he's been tripped up by Microsoft Word track changes. He's been tripped up by backing his encrypted texts up to the cloud. And now today, all of these details leaking out because his attorneys don't know how to properly redact documents before filing them with the court. And this is a big new bombshell because this is, you know, information that he very much didn't want us to know. That in the midst of his time working on behalf of Donald Trump, he was in Madrid meeting with a Russian intelligence asset and sharing confidential polling information from the campaign. And remember, one of the things that we know that Russia was doing was very carefully tailoring their messages from the Internet Research Agency and even potentially from the documents that they were leaking via WikiLeaks to what was going to resonate with voters. So this might be sort of step one in a collusion investigation. This is a potentially very significant document, partially because Robert Mueller says that he has evidence that Konstantin Kilimnik was an asset of Russian intelligence during the campaign in 2016. We don't know what that evidence is. Mueller hasn't shared it, but Mueller has reason to believe Konstantin Kilimnik was working for Russian intelligence at this time.
Mm-hmm. Konstantin Kilimnik, I knew you'd say it better than I did. You re-raised the mystery around his grand jury appearances last year. What do we know?
Well, remember, he lied about a whole bunch of different things as part of this plea agreement. This is the
heart
of this dispute.
Although he says he didn't mean to lie, right, according to the news today.
Sometimes he just didn't recollect things correctly.
Right.
And Mueller is saying, though, in his court filings, that Paul Manafort was in front of a grand jury at least twice during the course of the fall of 2018. And again, that's significant because you have to know from Mueller's court filings that Mueller was thinking that Paul Manafort was lying. And so if he knows that he's lying, that means that he has documentary evidence involved in that grand jury to box in Paul Manafort's testimony. And we haven't actually seen what grand jury indictment or case that was tied to and sort of what the public fruits may be of Paul Manafort appearing behind that grand jury.
What about this Russian lawyer, Natalia Veselnitskaya? She's the one who tried to, or who helped organize that 2016 Trump Tower meeting. She was the one who set it up, right, to provide the dirt on Hillary Clinton, and now she's the one being charged, although it is a separate investigation, by federal prosecutors in New York. How, even though it's separate, how might this, Garrett, play into or affect the bigger Mueller investigation?
Well, again, what you have is more color being added to this picture of the various ways that Russia was attempting to influence the campaign in 2016. And so what we learn in these new court filings in this Southern District of New York case, which relates to 2015-2014 civil money laundering investigation by the Southern District federal prosecutors in Manhattan is that this Russian lawyer, who, as you said, was at the center of this Trump Tower meeting in June 2016, was just months prior working hand in hand with the Russian government and was closely coordinating her actions with the Kremlin. And so what it begins to do is underscore that this is someone who is very tightly connected to the Russian power structure and was unlikely to be freelancing by showing up at Trump Tower on her own volition to offer some help to the Trump campaign. And in fact, what we are beginning to see is that, in fact, she was probably there under the direct coordination of senior members of the Russian government up to and in part possibly including Vladimir Putin himself.
Why, my goodness. Garrick Raff, good to see you. Thank you very much.